In February 2014, thousands of graduates of air traffic control schools learned their dreams had been crushed. The primary path to a job in America's towers, a path established years before by the FAA, was suddenly abandoned.
Their degrees were now irrelevant. Scores on the ATSAT test ignored. Worse, the grads had been deemed ineligible to become controllers. Why? A murky and strange biographical personality test newly implemented by the FAA to select candidates.
Being a military aviator was my lifelong goal, and I achieved that goal. Air traffic control was a very, very solid fallback plan. I was using the GI Bill, going to community college in my hometown.
Then a grateful nation thanked you by saying you were ineligible. How did you feel?
This was just completely incongruent with any logical sense.
There's no information for us to understand how we can improve or what we can focus on to make ourselves a better candidate for the FAA.
I contacted senators and representatives and no one could get an answer.
Anybody ever say what made you eligible or not eligible?
We've asked that question also. And members of Congress have asked the FAA.
The FAA made some very dramatic changes to the way they're hiring our air traffic controllers. Nobody understands what this biographical questionnaire is evaluating or why they're not making it through.
I'll have Michael Huerta from the FAA reach out directly to you.
This to me is really troubling.
So let me read to you what the FAA says. This test has been proven to be a valid instrument for assessing experience, work habits, education, and dimensions that are related to success on the job.
And yet, just months later, the FAA published a different, conflicting report titled, Using Biodata to Select Air Traffic Controllers. It says, based on an analysis of the relationship between certain biodata items and training success, we conclude that the evidence for using these biodata items for controller selection is weak.
Makes no sense. Where's the logic behind it? If it's weak, then why would you use it?
They just based an entire hiring force on biographical data, and now they're saying that it's weak?
By all accounts, what's driving these changes in hiring of air traffic controllers is a program to promote diversity in the nation's control towers.
Diversity is a noble goal. I'm not going to sit here and deny that.
It generates a better atmosphere when you have people from different backgrounds, and I completely agree with it.
Back in 2013, the FAA Office of Civil Rights published a massive barrier analysis on the impediments or barriers for minorities. It states the first steps of the original hiring process are the most likely places for systematic adverse impact because these steps are responsible for the vast majority of fails. It also says the CTI program is much less diverse than off-the-street hires.
The barrier analysis,
right,
concluded that you're not diverse.
We had completed a diversity study which showed that we were showing significant progress in helping the diversity within the FAA air traffic controller ranks.
Lucas, are you African American?
Yeah.
They threw you away.
Either they've got enough African Americans or that they don't really know what they want.
Matthew, you're Native American, right?
Correct.
Miranda, female. What do you think?
I think that they had a goal and they went about it the wrong way.
A former air traffic controller himself, Mike Pearson, now works as an aviation lawyer.
It's my belief that the FAA is engaged in a pattern of discrimination and now they're covering it up.
Pearson and others believe diversity advocates strong-armed the FAA into changing its hiring practices.
You had social engineering, in my belief, my opinion, going on. It was driven by two arms of the FAA, two different organizations. One was the Human Resources Group, and I believe there was another group engaging in what I believe is discrimination against qualified candidates.
What is that organization?
The NBCFA.
The National Black Coalition of Federal Aviation Employees.
Excuse me, National Black Coalition of Federal Aviation Employees.
The coalition is an umbrella group for various minorities. Anybody considered a minority can join.
The NBCFAE had formed a team to try to change the hiring process. Now, they're certainly allowed to advocate for their group. That's legal. The one thing they're not allowed to do is advocate for a group at the exclusion of another group.
Pearson suspects the FAA abandoned the well-established CTI training program and threw away qualified and well-trained graduates to bring in off-the-street hires without aviation degrees, and that way achieve greater diversity.
Social engineering at the risk of compromising safety.
But there's more. The advocacy on the part of NBC FAE appears to go far beyond a change in hiring practices. Fox Business obtained a troubling recording made by an FAA employee who's also an NBC FAE executive.
I'd like to play something for you.
Associate members, brothers and sisters, listen. I know that each of you are eager, very eager, to apply for this job vacancy announcement. And trust, after tonight, you will be able to do so.
It was sent as an audio text to certain applicants who were already members of the organization.
Allow me to go to work and come home, provide you with an email that will be extremely crucial in the opening stages of this hiring process. There are some valuable pieces of information that I have taken a screenshot of, and I'm going to send that to you via email. I'm about 99.99% sure that it's exactly how you need to answer each question in order to get through the first phase.
Utterly disgusting.
This is handing out the answers.
That is absolutely sickening. That is cheating at the most unacceptable, highest level that I've ever seen right there. Pure and simple cheating.
Coming up.
It's my belief that the FAA is hiding the truth.
Yeah, it sounds like cheating. It sounds like someone inside getting information out to people.
There are people from the NBC FAE who say you gave them the answers on the test. Well, who do I speak to about this?
No comment.